Doesn't mean if the dollar pulls back a little bit more, it won't have a small bounce. But I'm hard pressed to find a scenario where Bitcoin doesn't at least go to 12 to 13,000 before putting in a bottom. And I have a worst case scenario that's well below 10,000 on Bitcoin. So I think it's important for Bitcoin investors to realize that this is the first bear cycle that the Fed is not printing money enduring, right? And so you have to take that into account when you're doing your cycle. So if previous cycles saw an 80 to 85% correction, you got to think this one would at least do 80 to 85%, which would be 12, 13,000, mm-hmm. and it might even do more.
Hey guys, welcome back to Library of Wealth. Today we have Bitcoin analyst Gareth Soloway giving his take on the drop in cryptocurrency across the market. He also discusses how the Federal Reserve had been artificially pumping the stock markets through excessive money printing, but that since the US government can no longer print money to support the economy, there will be a correction. Gareth Soloway explains it's important to follow the trend line and not to listen to fear in the market. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoy what we do here on this channel. Let's get right into the video.
Yeah, so I think overall it's a negative, right? Anytime you have this potential geopolitical scenario, especially after Russia invaded Ukraine, it just opens a possibility that it could happen with Taiwan. It definitely puts people on the back burner. Now, the key is this market has been going up and down inversely to the US dollar. And we know that the more geo-instability, the more upside on the dollar, right? More people hide in the US dollar for safety. And so that, again, just right there is a negative for equity markets, for crypto markets, for gold. Nicely enough, we have potentially seen a major reversal in the dollar today. So we might be seeing a short-term top there, which would be positive for risk assets. Because what you're seeing is essentially is the Fed is trying to lead this push and they're talking so aggressively hawkish. Now, I believe it's a lot of talk. I'm curious once we tick into recession, how quickly they back off from this hawkish talk. But I think they're trying to talk a tough game to make sure that inflation kind of stalls out here and does come in. But I do think raising rates sucks money out of the system, right? So just like printing and lowering rates drives money into the system, it makes money free or at least cheap. The opposite is occurring. So it's a supply-demand economics problem where when you take dollars out of the system, inevitably the dollar should strengthen. And especially since we're acting more aggressively than the ECB or the Japanese Central Bank, it's going to strengthen the dollar against those currencies.
Soloway is bothered by not seeing enough disruption in the cryptosphere, as even Ethereum is still considerably down. Gareth wonders if this is the bottom, how can so many coins still exist, and if we're heading up, how this will play out in the future. He also explains that even though the Fed will stop hiking later this year, the reason why they're implementing this is because we will be seeing an extremely destructive event coming down the line. NASDAQ is actually starting to collapse, and along with the stock market's downfall, this will actually strengthen Bitcoin.
You know, so it's a weird time right now because you're coming off of the COVID lockdowns and stuff like that. And then obviously there was the surge and then kind of the reflex retraction there. So I think it's one of the most hard times to really figure out what is a recession, what isn't. For me, what I'm going to look at is I'm going to look at the jobs numbers. You start to see a significant uptick in unemployment. We did see a tiny uptick in unemployment last Friday, but it was mostly due to people coming back to the workforce. I think that over the next few months, you're going to see that unemployment rise to 4%, a little bit above. And then once we see the GDP numbers remain weak plus that, then it's like, okay, this is a no-brainer official recession that you could call it that at that point. I mean, I have it penciled in for a 50 basis point at the end of September hike. So again, for me, now there's a lot of talk and the markets are even saying it could be 75 basis points. I'm thinking the Fed is, at least I hope they're smart enough to understand that they can't, and it's very dangerous to continue aggressively hiking rates. Because again, each rate hike takes a certain amount of time to work its way through the economy, right? Mm-hmm. So if you hike three times in a row, 75 basis points, and then all of a sudden in 6 months, we're in a deep recession, ask yourself, how do we get out of that recession? Because every past recession, the Fed has come to the market's rescue. QE, QE1, QE2, QE2. And I mean, you just went on all the way through COVID with printing money and lowering rates. And so the Fed can't do that anymore with inflation as high as it is. So I really hope they're careful. I think that they're starting to see those signs of weakness creeping in like they want, the inflation numbers coming down. And I think that would be the goal here to start that. They can always do 50 again later in the year if they want to, but starting to just bring it down a notch would be a very confidence boosting thing for the economy and for the markets. My thinking of and why I'm net longer term bearish is that I do see us going into a recession, even if they start kind of coming down on the hikes less and less, we're still headed into a full-fledged recession. And again, I think once the market realizes the Fed can't bail us out of this recession, the market's going to freak out. It's going to say, okay, this could be a long drawn out recession, making up for all the lack of recessions that we've seen over the past 10 plus years. And that could be this kind of stagflationary kind of period in the markets. And I think that's the culprit for the next big leg down that takes us down to the COVID, the pre-COVID low highs from 2020 and even below. Definitely something I paid attention to, because I think it's like that first showcase that governments are going to be very aware of economic hardships. And so, you know, everyone says that, you know, the Fed can't print. And I've even said that to you, that it's going to be tough for the Fed to print when inflation is still elevated. But I do think that there is a point. I mean, there will be a tipping of the scale where if things get bad enough, even if inflation's at 4%, the Federal Reserve will start to print again. I mean, imagine inflation's at 4%, but unemployment's at 15%, right? You can't tell me that the Fed's not going to try to stimulate, that the government and the politicians that are trying to get reelected are not going to try to stimulate. They will absolutely. So there's this point where things will get so bad, they will start to print again. And that's where gold becomes key. I mean, so many of these metals and inflationary things, like even Bitcoin at a certain point becomes a no-brainer. And I think South Korea was just kind of that shot across the bow. It wasn't any major intervention. It just shows the willingness for governments to step in when things get rough.
Soloway believes that most currencies should be wiped out. With only the top 50 coins surviving, then new money will be able to come out that have fantastic use cases. Gareth says that speculating on the 1,001 currencies by market cap needs to be wiped out, and only assets with legitimate use cases remaining. Soloway notes that watching inflation comes down to watching the economic numbers and seeing how quickly the economy is slowing down. If abysmal economic numbers are seen, markets will begin to panic about a recession coming. And if inflation can only be pulled back by about 6% and we're in recession, the Fed can't just print more money, which will take us to the next leg lower in the markets. What do you guys think about Gareth Soloway's prediction of the impact of inflation in the current markets, as well as the crypto landscape? Let us know in the comments below. Guys, thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. This is Library of Wealth. We'll see you in the next video.